welcome participants for the sixth day of STDP on finite element analysis for engineering application. Hope this will be the last session in this STDP. So in this session, I am going to deal static, structural, and steady state thermal analysis using ANSYS workbench. So I am going to do this session only in the practical way using that ANSYS workbench software. So I am not going to do a deep analysis. So if I do a deep analysis, the meshing will take more time. So I am going to do some basic structural and steady state thermal analysis. So hope this will create you an interest to learn ANSYS workbench. If you are knowing a basics about ANSYS workbench, and if you want to learn further deep into the ANSYS workbench, definitely this session will create you interest, I think. So before going to do a case study problem, I want to tell some basic things about ANSYS workbench. What are all the tools available and how the structural and steady state thermal analysis can be made. So ANSYS workbench is having, ANSYS family products is having a lot of softwares. So in that, I am just denoting only three important software, which creates more interest for me to learn analysis portions. So one is ANSYS workbench, and the second one is CFX, and the third one is ICM CFD. So ANSYS workbench, you all know the all type of analysis, whether it is a structural or thermal, or whether we need to do any optimization work. So all can be done using ANSYS workbench. And CFX, the minor CFD solvers can be made using CFX. If you want to do a complicated CFD analysis, we can go for ICM CFD, where a lot of complication CFD analysis can be made. And these are all the five important modules in ANSYS workbench. So one is design modeler, and the next one is design explorer, simulation, CFX mesh, and FE modeler. And in case of design modeler, we can create any model. So obviously we are creating a model using SolidWorks, CATIA, or GUI. So all types of model can be made in ANSYS also, where in design modeler we can do. And after doing that model, we can mesh it and make a simulation, and we can generate a result. So these are all the comprised five modules of ANSYS workbench. So we will see in detail in the case study session. And apart from this, we can import the model. So we are creating a model in design modeler, using a design modeler. But if you don't want to design the model in ANSYS itself, if you are well familiar with SolidWorks or PO or any other modeling software, Solid Edge or Inventor, so there we can create a model, and directly we can import that model into the ANSYS. So while importing the model, we have to convert the FileWorks into a common file term, whether it is a STEP or IGES. In some latest ANSYS software, SolidWorks file itself is accepting. But if you are using older version, you can convert the created model into IGES or STEP file, so that the importing will be more easier and more perfect. So these are creating a model. We are using a direct CAD modeler. For example, SolidWorks and Solid Edge, we are creating a solid direct CAD modeler. But in case of if you are doing a minor analysis, direct modeling in ANSYS is will help more in case of analysis portion. So I will show you in detail in a practical session how we can import the model, and also how we can generate a model in CAD modeler in ANSYS itself. And these are all the different analysis we can make. Apart from this, lot of analysis are there, but I'm highlighting the basic important analysis. Static structural analysis, which we are going to see now, model analysis, harmonic analysis, buckling analysis, random vibration, random spectrum, transient structural thermal. The thermal can be steady state thermal, and transient thermal analysis can also be made using this ANSYS workbench. So I will show you all in case study section. Important tools in structural analysis. So importing the model and meshing the model and the static analysis portion. So how we can fix, where we can fix, and how the load can be applied. So all different tools are available in the structural analysis portion. So complex task can also be made using this structural analysis. And moving to material. So material plays a major role in analysis. So if you want to get an accurate analysis, definitely material will help. So choosing a right material is very important. So here a material library is available. Lot of materials are there. We can import from the library. Default material will be a structural steel. So if you want to use, if you want to import more material, we can take from the library. That also I will show. And these are all the important materials, that is metallic and the elasticity material and rubber material, polymer, and some composite materials also we can import. I will show you all those things. And meshing, in some softwares we need to mesh, we need to do a meshing in a separate software, and then we need to import that meshing component into the working software. But in case of workbench, we can mesh directly in the workbench itself. The mesh will be quite accurate. We can change the size of the mesh, and the mesh can be made easily when compared to the other specific mesh softwares. So direct one click is enough to do the meshing. So I will plotting result is also easier one. So we can take all types of results which is possible in the created component, whether it is a stress or deformation or temperature distribution. So whatever possibility results are there in that created model, we can take it easily. So also we can take the report. So after creating all the analysis, after generating the results, we can generate the report in all the format, whether HTML, Word or PowerPoint. So if you want to present your analysis in PowerPoint, we can directly generate the report in PowerPoint mode. If you want to write any journal papers in Word document, we need to take the material properties and parameters which we are using, and the model diagram which we drawn, and the analysis we made, what are the options we used. So those reports can be generated in Word itself. So this will be much helpful for writing papers, research papers. So I am writing most of the research papers using this report only. So I will show you all in practical session. So let us move to the case study portion. So this is the case study problem I have taken, a simple frame structure. The frame structure is constructed with the structural steel, that is the default material available in workbench, and I-beams of given cross section. So this beam, this frame is having the cross section of I, and the dimension is mentioned in the problem, and it is used to support a uniform load 6 kilonewton as shown in the figure. So all the frames is having a 6 kilonewton uniform load is applying. So this is the problem I have taken. So using ANSYS workbench, determine the deformation and stresses in the frame members. So this can be analyzed, the deformation and stresses can be calculated theoretically. That is what we have seen in the 5 days session. Now I am going to show how this frame structure can be analyzed in ANSYS workbench, how deformation and stresses can be calculated. So I will show you. I will stop sharing the slide and open the workbench module. Just hold for some time. I think the ANSYS screen is visible. Ramanathan sir, is it visible?
Ah, yes, sir. It is visible, sir. Visible.
Thank
it
you.
Is Ravindran, sir. It is visible.
So this is the home screen of Ansys Workbench. Yesterday itself, in the second session, we learned some of the composite material analysis. So in that session, the basic things and all not covered. So I am going to teach some basic things, how the structural and steady state analysis is made. So we have taken a beam problem. I think you better take a screenshot of this problem, then only you will understand while drawing this. So I'm sharing again that PPT. You just make a screenshot, then only you can able to follow. Just participants, kindly take a screenshot of this problem. So the length is 1.2 meters, so all dimensions are in meter. And the width is 0.5, I section dimension is given. And the height is 0.6, equally divided into 0.3 and 0.3. So all is applied with a uniform load of 6 kilonewton per meter. So this is what, I think these four legs are the fixed support we are going to do. So make a screenshot. So this is the toolbox. So five different toolboxes are there: analysis system, component system, custom systems, design exploration, and the external connection systems. So in this, the basic analysis can be done in analysis system. So lot of analysis can be made, whether it is an electric analysis or fluid flow. So all type of analysis, model and rigid dynamics also we can do. So here static structural analysis is there, and the steady state thermal analysis is there. So these two analysis we are going to do now. So first we will do a static structural analysis. So here is static structural. We just click it and drag the tool and keep it here. Okay, so all the portions can be dragged and keep it, and simultaneously you can import the same model into various analysis. So here first option is engineering data. Just double click it, you will get the material portions gets open. So here the default material is structural steel. You can see here structural steel is here. So here engineering data sources, when you click this, you will get what are all the materials available. So here see general material, explicit, thermal material, fluid material. So all material categories here, aluminium alloy, concrete, so magnesium alloy, so all types of material is there. So if you want to use a specific material, you can import from here. So here default material is structural steel. This symbol shows that we have chosen structural steel. So if you want to choose stainless steel, you can click this and add this into stainless steel. So now we no need that. So just you click only structural steel. So these are this is the material. I'm going to delete this. So I'm using only structural steel. So only structural steel we are going to use. So let us go to the project. So that's all, we have selected the material. Then go to geometry. So here double click it. So the ANSYS screen gets opened. Is it open?
Yeah, it is open, sir.
Okay. Just right click it, give edit geometry. So you will find the ANSYS screen. I think one more screen is there. I need to share that one, model screen. Just hold for. So this was the model screen. It will get open. So here we need to sketch that problem. I think, hope all have taken a screenshot. So it is a problem of a frame structure. So we are going to model that frame structure using the screen. So this is the design modeler screen. So choose the XY plane. The plane will be in different direction. Click this one. So it will come into right direction where X and Y axis will be correct. So here 0 to 40 meter length is the screen size, which is defaultly available. So based on the problem we have taken, we have to zoom this properly. So our problem is having a maximum of how much length? So length is 1.2 meter and the width is 0.5 meter. So maximum is we can take up to 1.5 meter. So here 0 to 40 meter, so it is quite long. So just click here and drag the mouse. You can see the we are zooming it and the zooming screen is gets decreasing. You see, so now 0 to 1 meter is our screen. So the length of the frame which we are drawing is quite can be viewed easily in this screen. So the 0 to 1 meter I have selected. So just I'm going to sketch it. So click sketch line. So just roughly I'm going to draw the base of that frame. So from here, one line of approximate length. And similarly from here, approximate length. Joining these two. So you can click anywhere, the line will be straight. So only thing we need to make it clear that while selecting the line, the oval symbol should be visible. So then only you are, it means that you are selecting the lines. So that's a rough sketch I have made. Now go to dimension. So we need to give the dimension exactly in the problem. So dimension. So first I'm going to select the length of the frame. So length of the frame I have taken as L2. Then height of the frame, total height of the frame, L3, and the second, one second. Total height, and that second frame will is having first, we will put the exact dimension of this height and length. So first L2, here L2 is there. So in the problem, we are having 1.2 meter, I think. So 1.2 meter and the height is L5. So here we can take as, according to the problem, it is 0.6 meter. This is also 0.6, and the distance between these two, 1.2 by 2, that is L9. So this we can take it as 0.6. So it is already 0.6. Second. One second, hold on. I opened two ANSYS. It is getting confusion. So I will share again. So same line I am drawing. Okay, go to dimension, give the vertical length, horizontal length, give vertical length, and give this lower portion. Okay, so L1, now L1 is 1.2 and L2 is 0.6 and L3 is, I think, 0.6 by 2, it is 0.3. And from this to this, I am going to fix into center. So this is L1 divided by 2. That is, L1 is 1.2. So L4 will be 0.6. So that's all. We have created a rough sketch of the frame. So now go to generate. So now the sketch can be created. Then when you see the problem, take the screenshot of the problem, you will have the width of, I think it is 0.5. So we need to draw create an offset plane of about 0.5 length. Then only we create that sketch by joining the points. I will show you. So first go to concept and the lines from sketches. We need to select this sketch. So select this sketch and give apply. So now the sketches has been selected. Now go to create body transformation. So before that, click generate, create body transformation, and translate. This is the tool we can use for creating an offset sketch. Okay, the same similar can be mirrored at a distance of 0.5 meter. Translate, select this body. So this body will be selected, apply, and how much offset you need. So for that, select the coordinates. Based on the coordinates, we are going to create an offset. So here it is a z coordinate. So select z coordinate minus, so towards right side, so minus 0.5 meter. So give enter. So here you can see the offset plane. Okay, now create generate, and then one more tool is there. We have created a same mirror sketch of this frame, and we are going to join this one using a point option. That is, go to concept, line from points. So just click the points and drag this, you can create a line. Similarly, so I'm zooming it, click this point, join this line. So one more point is here, click this. Where is that? So we have created, we have joined all the points. So now the frame structure we have got. So if we click apply and you give generate, so when you click the body, you can see the lines are joined, but this is yellow color and this is blue color, which means that the portions which we have drawn earlier is not properly constrained with the generated portion. Okay, so we need to create a constraint. So for that, So go to again concept. So line from sketches, click that one and click the sketch which we want to get constrained with the drawn sketch. So this is what the sketch we have drawn earlier. So the sketch has been selected. Give apply and give generate. So now you select the body. So everything will be in yellow color. So properly constrained and a perfect frame structure has been made. So this is the frame structure only we have created. So in that problem, when you see the problem, it is given as I section. Cross section is I section. So each this beam, each beam which will be of I section. So for that, we need to create a cross section, and then we need to just attach that cross section into all these frames. That is what I am going to do. So for that, go to concept. Go to concept, cross section. There is a lot of sections are there, rectangular, circular, I section. So here in our problem, we have to select I section. Just select it. So you will get an I section. So in some softwares, we need to draw this manually, but sorry, using a modeler portion. But here you can import directly. All the sections can be imported. So I section. So only thing we need to change the direction, sorry, dimension based on the problem. So what is the problem? Just to take the screenshot of the problem. So I couldn't able to swap the share. So it is showing that the length of this, that is W1 and W2 is 25. And then height is, that is W3 is 80. So here 0.1 meter is default. So default unit is meter. But we need in mm. So go to tools, sorry, units, and change the units into mm. So this 100 mm default is coming. So W1 should be 25 according to our problem, and W2 is also 25, and W3 is 80. And what is thickness? So W1. So T1, T2, so everything is a 5 according to the problem. Just 5, 5, 5. So give enter. So you have got the exact sketch of the problem. So now click generate. Okay, so this is the sketch of according to the dimension of the problem. So now go to body. So there we can see this is the structure we have created. Here cross section is showing that not selected. So click this one and you can see the cross section which we have created before. So select that one and click generate. So that's all, the cross section has been created. Now we have to add that cross section. So concept, sorry, tools. Go to view option, because if you merge that cross section, there will be a lot of lines, dimensioning lines and all. So we need to just frozen body transparency so as to create an exact model. So to avoid to increase the visualization, so just untick the frozen one and then go to cross section solids. So now you can see the cross section which we have created has been merged with the sketch which we have created. Okay, this is what the exact frame which we are seeing in the problem. So, but here some unaligned portions are there. You can see here some unaligned portions are there. So you need to correct that. So for that, go to a line body and give a right click. Select unaligned line edges. So those lines, these are the unaligned lines portions. So we need to make an alignment of these portions in the portions. So for that, I'm going to select that first this line, and you will get the details. So in that, I'm going to develop develop a model for 1 meter, that is along y-axis. So first select this line as a vector 1, make this as 0, and for y coordinate you put 1. You can see that the structure has been properly aligned. So likewise, all the frames has to be properly aligned along with the section. So we have selected I section, and we have merged the same section with the structure which we have made. But actual I section should be correctly aligned with the structure which we have created. For that only we are using this option. So again, this line. So I am selecting this line. So go to selection, create vector, and along y-axis put 1, and you can find this also properly aligned. Similarly, this portion, go to selection, give vector, remove this as 0 and put this as 1. So you can see this also properly aligned, and the remaining last portion is this one. Select this one, vector, use 0 and 1. So now you can see the properly made structure, that is frame structure, as it is in the problem which is given. So I am removing the dimensional and extra lines. So now you can see here it is properly aligned. Frame has been created as per the problem of height 0.6 and the length is 1.2 meter and the width of the frame is 0.5 meter. So all the thickness is 0.5 meter. So everything has been properly made. So now that's all. We have created a model. Now we are going to do the analysis. So as per the problem, so now take a screenshot and look out the problem. So it is given as the uniform load 6 kilonewton is acting all over this portion and also this portion. So we need to give the uniform load of 6 portion. So it is a frame structure. So definitely this 4 will be the fixed support. So giving this as a fixed support and make a line pressure of 6 kilonewton all over this section and also this section, and make a analysis, and we can see how much deformation and stresses will be acting over the frame. So let us go to the analysis portion. So that's all. Just we can, it is automatically saved on the design modeler. You can close this. Now I'm sharing the actual ANSYS screen. See here, so geometric portion get ticked. So which means we have created the model. Now go to the model portion. So just right click it. So model portion has been open. I will share that portion. So this is what the screen you will get after clicking the model. So here you can see the structure which we have created. So yeah. So first and foremost step. So these are all the tools. So model is having as a line body we have given. We can rename it as a frame structure. And the first step is we need to mesh. So whatever analysis we are doing, first step is we need to divide this portion into minute smaller elements so as to make the analysis an accurate one. So how much size of mesh we are giving. So if you give a small size of mesh, the result will be more accurate. So just to create the mesh, click the mesh, and you can generate and also update. So both are both you can give. So now I am going to give update. So wait for some time, the mesh will get created. So I think you can see the meshed element, that is the meshed frame structure. Okay, so next we will give the loading condition. So next step is loading condition. Go to static structural, click right click it, insert. So lot of loading structures are there, lot of loading options are there. So first we can give the fixed support. So fixed support, select all the four edges of the frames. So here you can select the point. So give the point and keep apply. So now one is fixed. Similarly, four remaining edges should be fixed. So you can right click this fixed support and make a duplicate of the support. So three times duplicate. So now you are having four fixed support. So click the second one and select the second point. Click apply. And the third support will be on third leg. Apply. Fourth is over the fourth leg. Click apply. So now when you click the static structural, you can see all the four fixed support where we have given. So these four portions are fixed. So now according to the problem, take the problem. So this frame will be acting with 6 kN and this will be acting with 6 kN uniform load. So for that, go to static structural, go to insert. So here you can see line pressure is there. So we are going to give the pressure of 6 kN over that line. Okay, so now click this line, apply. So the line has been applied without any pressure, zero pressure. So click the magnitude, and if you click any if you put the data that is given in the problem, that is 6000, it will create either horizontally or vertically. So for that, we need to change the direction of the load. So for that, click the direction to components. So based on the components, that is x coordinate, y coordinate and z coordinate. So here we need to give downward, that is y coordinate. So click y coordinate, and if it is downward, put -6000. Give enter. So now you can see the total line of the structure. Total structure has been acted with 6 kN uniformly. Then you have to create 1, 2, 3 and extra 7 frames are there. So for that, as like fixed support, make a duplicate of this line pressure also 7 times. 2, 3, 7, then 8. So now we have taken the line pressure duplicate of 7. So far we need to fix the respective frames. Click the line pressure 2, click here, give apply. So -6000 will be acted here. Then line pressure 3, click here, give apply. Line pressure 4, click here. Apply. Line pressure 5, click here. 6, so all the frames, 7, 8. So he given all the loading conditions. So now click the static structural. So here you can see how the load is applied all over the structure. So as given in the problem, so 6000 newton, that is 6 kN is applied all over the beam, 6 kN uniform load. So now you can go for solving the problem. So before that, what are all the result we need? So for that, click solution, right click it, insert. So according to the problem, we need a deformation and stress. So give deformation, total deformation. Here you can take the result. Then again, right click, go to in deformation, direct deformation is there, and here stresses will be there. And also in beam tool, you can get direct stress, minimum combined stress, and maximum combined stress. So all types of possible results can be taken. See here, probe result, strain, stress, energy, force reaction. So all possible result according to this structure, we can extract the result. So now I have taken total deformation and direct stress. Go to solve solution, and you can solve here also, and also here also tool is available to solve. So just solve it. So it will take some time. So I think the problem has been solved, and direct stress has been generated, total deformation, minimum combined stress, and maximum combined stress. So these four results which we have given has been generated. So now click the total deformation, and you can take the result of the beam which is given in the problem. So this is the maximum, red color is the maximum deformation, that is 0.00139. Okay, it is in meter. 0.00139, the unit is meter, and minimum stress will be 0, which is in blue color. So this is the stress, then deformation, then click direct stress. So here the maximum stress is 9.76 Pascal, the minimum stress is -1.7 into 10 to the power 7 Pascal. The maximum is 9.76 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. So like this, all the results can be taken. So if you want, so that's all about static structure. It's quite easier. So this is a simpler component. So you just learn this simple component, and using this technique, you can create, you can generate all the analysis value, whether it is a complex or simple. So all can be made easily using this ANSYS software. So if you are familiar with other modeling software, you can use that, you can create the model in that respective software, and you can import that model into ANSYS and make analysis. So that's all about. So now here you can animate and see, here animation option is there. So you can animate and see how much stress is acting, and deformation and animation can also be made. So now I am going to show how the report can be generated. So I already said for writing a research paper, we can take all the data from this workout ANSYS workbench itself. So whether it is a material properties or parameters which we are using on the diagram, so all those things. For that, so just click the line body first, and this is the line which structure which we have made. So here there is an option called new figure. So just click it and click a figure. So this will be captured as a JPEG. So here you can see. Similarly, the one more result we need, if you want meshing portion also, you can take. So this, click the meshing portion and go to figure and capture this as a, then go to deformation, this, go to figure, one second, this figure gets generated. Similarly, direct stress figure has been generated, and then maximum stress. Maximum combined stress. So for all we have generated a figure, that is we have captured a figure. Now we can go for generating report. Here you can see print preview and report preview. This is a print preview. So from this also you can download, but go to report preview. So here report getting generated. So see here, all the figures are getting mapped, and thus the report has been cleared. So at what time you did this? What is the image you have captured? What are all the material properties you have chosen? So we have taken a structural steel. So default material properties will be there in the software itself. So you can use these data. If you want to do the same analysis mathematically, you can use these data and the structure and the coordinate system, what type of mesh we have given, and the meshing portions. So everything it gets generated. So all the portion, this is the deformation image, deformation results which we get, and those interpretation. So what is the minimum value? So all the values will be can be taken. So this is definitely helpful. So this is a simple structure. If you want to write a research paper on ANSYS, you can do a complex structure as per your idea, and take all the results value from here. This is all the result value, maximum combined stress, so all the value. So this can be downloaded in Microsoft Word. Go see this option. So that is an option called send to. So when you click this, you can download as a PPT and also Microsoft Word. So I'm clicking Microsoft Word. So it's get downloaded. I will share that. See here, the complete report has been downloaded in Word. So you can take these values. Every data can be taken. So this is all about the structural analysis using Workbench. So if you want to ask any doubt, you can ask. So now this portion, static structural portion, has been over. So here you can see is steady state thermal. So just click it and drag. Okay, you will find the similar to static structural tab, steady state thermal tab is there. So engineering data, so default structural steel, so don't disturb that. If you want to change the material, so as I said before, you can change. Now just I'm creating on geometry. A simple geometry, just it will take only 5 minutes, just hold on. So I am opening that modeler screen. So this is the modeler screen, which as usual, click the XY plane. And I'm not going to give any dimension. Just 0 to 10 meter I have kept. So just go to sketching. So I'm just going to draw one tubular structure. So for that, select circle, click here, draw one circle, draw another circle. So if you want to change the dimension, you can use the dimension tool. So in that diameter tool is there. So I'm just changing one thing. So click this. In rough sketch, you have draw 11 meter. So it's quite long. So I am just drawing as 2.5, that is 3 meter. Similarly, this one. Sorry, since a lot of tabs are there. So just we will proceed with rough sketch. So two different circles has been created. Then go to generate and create an extrude. So in that model, apply. Give generate. You will get an extrusion of the portion which we drawn. So it is an 1 meter extrusion. So if you want to increase the length, give here as I am giving as 5 meter. Give generate. So you can see as a 5 meter. So further, you want to increase, give us 10. Generate. So 10 meter. So like that, you can vary the length of the extrusion. Then again, I am going to draw one more frozen material portion. So for that, again sketching, circle, one circle, and the lesser dia for another circle. Click generate. So here you can see we have created the model, that is part do and this solid. So we have created a separate solid. So like that, lot of solids can be created. Then one more sketch I am going to draw. Shoot 10 meter to generate. So we have created three different cubes. So from here, this can be used as a model. It's a simple model I have taken. So the inner temperature can be varied and the outer temperature can be varied, and you can see what are all the temperature distribution in various sections. So that we can do. So I'm closing this. So here you can see the extrude 2, I think. Extrude 2, let us make into a frozen material. So now you can see the variations. Okay. So now I'm going again back to the analysis. So hold for 2 minutes. So as like in structural, the model gets imported here, the created model. So as like first step is you need to mesh it. So update mesh. So only thing, the loading condition gets varied. So in structural, we are giving fixed support and some loading condition. So here some temperature variations can be given. So this is the structure, and go to steady state. And the temperature. So in that, the inner temperature I am giving as some value as 300, let it be 300. And again I am giving outer temperature as some about 100, let it be. So I am giving as approximately, and let the outer portion be the convection portion. So convection just to 25 film coefficient. So I have given all the loading conditions. So temperature of the inner, outer, and so this is what the difference. Only the loading condition gets varies. Okay, now go to analysis. For taking the solution as like structural, so I'm taking temperature and some heat flux I'm taking. Anything you want, you can take. So all types of result, so you can extract these two. So it gets solved there. Okay, it gets solved. I think SAMS of steady state. Instead of taking steady state, simple steady state, we have taken SAMS of. So that's what for this data, the result is not generated. So that's all about thermal. So same for report generation, you can follow the same procedure which we seen in. So I will show that screen steady state. So here see steady state thermal is there. So you can use this screen and use the same model which we are created here. So I'm just dragging it. Now open the model. I'll share that. So I will share that. So I think now you can see steady state thermal we have collected. It's loading, it's quite slow, just hold on. Update mess. Case messed. Insert temperature. So outer portion I'm giving as 100. Gain temperature. Inner portion I am giving as 300 and then convection outer portion is treated as convection, let it be 25. So now you solve and see, you can extract temperature, total heat flux, top temperature. So now solve it. So it is solving. So I think this session definitely will help you to induce some interest in ANSYS Workbench, I think. So that's all, it gets solved there. So now we go to temperature. So you can see the temperature distribution. So temperature distribution all over the structure. So it is a rough sketch. So the maximum temperature and what are all the distribution, 270 up to 100. So how the temperature gets distributed over the structure. Okay. So here I'll show you. The animation can be made. So that's all about steady state. So likewise, a lot of analysis can be made. So if we will meet in one more session and we will see some different analysis in case of fluem. So how the flow analysis are made. I thought of telling the basic one, but due to some time consumption, I'm just stopping over here. So thank you for the opportunity.